Hello, PlayStation planners, players, and pure geniuses. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the city of Poncho. It has been almost a month since my last video. With springtime picking up, work's been a little busy and crazy, but still gotta make time for the fun stuff. So here we are, part 6, the city of Poncho. So you guys saw a lot of added content in the introduction there. A lot of stuff added to the city, but I didn't forget this time about recording all of that progress. So while even though I haven't had the time to make a video, I have had some downtime, a few hours here and there, to build around and record while I'm doing it. Now that I've completed a couple of these projects, I'm going to get a couple of videos out here in quick succession. And get everybody all caught up on where we are. I hope everybody's as excited for summertime as I am. I have been super pumped with this winter and how it's been for the nice weather. So we're going to make kind of a broken up neighborhood here. The idea when I started building this neighborhood was I actually wanted to dive into building the airport, but I needed to open up one more tile so I could make direct interstate access to the airport. But I didn't have enough people yet to unlock that milestone, so I decided to do something out of the norm and start building in an area of the city I hadn't planned on building in yet, but I got all excited unlocking this tile and didn't realize I needed the one above it as well before I could start the airport. So I used the extra land that I had available to me and built a kind of a winding neighborhood. I actually went on Google Earth. As everybody who's been following along knows, I'm getting a lot of the inspiration for the design of this city off the city of Pueblo down in Colorado. And so I actually went on Google Earth and was looking up a lot of their suburbs that are built towards the outer edge of the city. And I mean, don't get me wrong, Pueblo pretty much is just a giant suburb. There isn't really a huge downtown to it. Or anything like that. There's a pretty decent rail yard there, and so I kind of decided to add, you know, a bit of the big city feel that you get from Colorado Springs and Denver to this city in an area like Pueblo, Colorado, if that ever became a big enough city to look like this. So this road layout was very, very directly inspired by a specific area of Pueblo. I can't remember the name of it now. It's been a while since I recorded all of this, but I am definitely more than pleased with how it all turned out, because I was very skeptical at first when I got started on this project, so. So that was the basic road layout. Now that we're all hooked up to the utilities, I'm gonna turn this all into district and start zoning it. So I kind of sped this up a lot faster than the rest of the video because this is a very slow going process. I don't just zone the whole neighborhood at once and then walk away and let it grow. I zone little tiny bits at a time and let that fill in, and then I'll zone a little bit more. It helps with a death wave, and then it also just kind of helps me keep track of the smaller details. You know, did I space out putting in a park or a school or something where I needed to? You know, working my way over little bits at a time really helps me make sure that I include everything in there that I'm trying to achieve. And with this neighborhood, by the end of it, the middle part never really quite got filled in the way that I was hoping to fill it in, so maybe that's a video for down the road. Make that look a lot nicer. It's a bit hectic, but that only shows in the finished product. Right now, everything was working really good. It wasn't until I got a lot of traffic in here that I started to change it up a little bit. I just kept having this growing demand for industry the entire time I was doing this. I don't know. I've never had to zone so much generic industry, and I mean, I've only got the one big industry going, you know, that, well, I guess I've got two. I've got the oil and I've got that big mine, the strip mine. I don't know. Lots of blue collar folks living here, I guess. So, yep, just slowly zoning in this neighborhood. And I wind up putting in a higher density area in there too, because even after building almost a third of a tile, I was still short of the population I needed by like 6,000 people. So, I think it was like 45,000 that I needed. I don't know. It might have been less than that, but I know I wanted to get a lot of people in a little area, so that bald patch there by the river, I wound up zoning higher density. And that's all in at the later on, of course. But yeah, I'm gonna finish getting this zoned in and then start putting down some landscaping. Make that place come alive and doing little bits of work here and there on other things, I guess. Sometimes you gotta take your eyes off the project at hand, you know, to bring forth fresh ideas. And I was just killing time too, letting all this just fill in, which that takes some time. I think this whole span of all these videos I put together was like almost 2 hours worth of building and stuff that I crunched down into about 30 minutes.
We'll be right back.
Well, that's a very sped up glimpse into how most of my building projects go on this. There's a lot of editing that goes into just showing the project at hand, because I wind up scrolling around the city and finding other little details to work on and stuff like that while I'm trying to think of something new or something that the city needs. So here we go, starting to pack in this denser population into this neighborhood here so we can really bump up the population for our new tile. Building the airport and the downtown are my favorite parts of building a city in city skylines. They're also the most intimidating to me. I build up my entire city to, work my way up to that skyline for the downtown and also build it around what's going to be the biggest transport hub for the community. So building up and preparing for those is a ton of fun. But once it gets to actually doing those projects, it can be kind of intimidating to me because they are both such defining things for the rest of your city. So the pressure is on, I feel like. Now that we spent all that time watching this neighborhood build itself and grow like plants out of the ground, we're gonna put in the rest here. See, and this was just a sloppy grid. I was just trying to get population, and then it just kind of never got torn down, so. Eesh. But let me know in the comments what you guys think about the downtowns and the airports. I feel like those are the biggest projects to be done in the city. So let me know in the comments what you guys think about that and what's the most challenging part for you in this game? Is it the transit? Is it the road layout? Is it just the general concept of the game? Let's hear about it. I'd definitely like to know. Well, just about wrapping this up now. The next video is going to be the airport. So, pretty excited for that project. But I think that's going to wrap it up for this one. I'll give a brief overview of what we've built today, and I'll see you guys in the next video.